Guys, we gotta go. We gotta go right fucking now. You guys know I'm not the alarming type, right? But I just pee-peed and poo-pooed so hard I made mustard gas in the toilet. Yeah, we're gonna have to sound some alarms and like evacuate the building. I'm gonna go get some towels.
Wait!
Yes?
Did you always have that beard?
Yes, it's last year. Anyway, I don't know how quick mustard gas spreads, so I'm just gonna bang on pots or something. I will like that should cause a loud enough noise, like people will probably evacuate on that. Just get one of the pots. I'm just gonna quickly.
Yeah, the beard looks really ugly.
Okay, thanks. We're gonna have to start really moving here because I don't think these towels are gonna do anything.
Yeah, I can't hear a thing over that disgusting fucking beard. You know, we should shave it. You would actually get a really funny idea.
What?
We should pitch that as the special bit, shaving Ferris's beard. Wouldn't that be something, huh?
That was so funny. You really bring an essence to it. You're so funny, man. Like, so funny.
Yeah. Hey, Ferris. It's been decided. We're shaving your beard for the special tonight. Ferris?
Guys, it's too late.
What? You're a plumber. Just fix the damn toilet already, you know?
It's not an issue of the toilet. It's an issue of what's coming out. Plumber, why? You guys know how mustard gas works?
That's the thing that turns people into sandwiches. It's why they call it mustard gas.
Precisely. It's Jake.
If that's Jake, and you're Brady, and you're Ferris, and I'm Yvonne.
Kenzie?
John?
We gotta get out of here!
How am I gonna tell Jake's mom?
Guys, this is seriously why you gotta start listening to me in the future, okay?
At least I was able to swipe the sandwich that wasn't contaminated before we left.
Wait. Did one of you guys take Bleebo? One of you guys brought my cat down, right?
No! 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 No!
The following is a special bulletin report from the Oracles of Next Week Now. Viewers who are ill-prepared for visions into a future yet revealed, please be advised. And now your news, 1 week in advance.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Next Week Now, Austin's number one fake news show. My name is Sammy the Spaceman, and I've been to space. Let me tell you guys, it's not all it's cracked up to be. When you spend as much time as I have staring into the dark, cold void of nothingness, there's nothing left to face but your inner demons. Oh. Also, there's aliens. Yeah, guys, aliens are real. And they're actually really chill. Me and Zorbnak, we're homies. He comes over for poker night every Friday. All right, on to the news. Today, the SAG-AFTRA strike ended. Yeah. Bad news for us here at Next Week Now. Yeah, it seems like our graphic team was inspired, and they want equal representation now, too.
Boo.
Half of the team abruptly quit right before the show, spitting in the producers' faces and turning in half-assed graphics until they replenished the prize box with tech decks, skateboards, and sticky hands. Liberals. A live-action Legend of Zelda movie was officially confirmed to be in production by Nintendo. We at Next Week Now have already put Chris Pratt in his kennel to prevent him from any further damage. And whoever doesn't get their bits finished on time has to clean his pee-pee pad. The first ever NFT convention, ApeCon, was struck with tragedy after installing UV lights instead of LEDs all around the space. This resulted in attendees reporting vision damage to the convention organizers. Man, looks like they need to invest in some laser eye surgery. Yeah. Am I right? Scientists are doing what now? A student of Rice University says that it is fun to experiment in soft robotics by killing spiders and using the dead creature's legs as part of some sort of hydraulic mechanics. Y'all remember those hydraulic press videos on YouTube? Yeah, maybe let's just leave the spiders out of it, please. There were no male artists on the Billboard top 10 chart this past week. Ha, I guess men really do just need to shut up sometimes. Am I right, ladies? Yep, I'm not like other guys. You can catch me playing guitar on Guad after this. If you want to have a super deep and sensitive conversation about, like, Maya Angelou or something else girls like, I'm down. The last song ever made by the Beatles has been released. The vocals of John Lennon were extracted from the original unusable demo using AI technology. Unfortunately, Paul McCartney has left the band due to creative differences with AI John Lennon. A golf course in Arizona was ransacked by, quote, a group of pig-like creatures. In related news, Next Week Now's annual trip to Arizona went very well. In more Arizona news, there's a London Bridge in Arizona, too. Wonder if it'll go down soon. Just like how I went down on your mom last night. Sick sex joke. What? We write good jokes? What? Oi, bruv. did you not know the Golden Lou was stolen years ago from a museum? Excuse me. Well, earlier this week, four men were charged in connection to said missing golden toilet. These men are expected to appear in court later in November. And I'll sure be there to watch to see if the men are innocent or if they're full of crap. Looks like somebody at Grubhub in Utah got one man's order wrong and delivered him a cup full of steaming urine instead of a milkshake. The driver said he got the order confused with another styrofoam cup in his car that he uses to relieve himself. Crazy theory. But what if the driver actually drank the milkshake and then peed in the same cup? I mean, technically it's still a milkshake. Just a different form? No? Food has to come out one way or the other. And he should be glad that it isn't... never mind. Holy sugar honey iced tea. Newsflash. Harry Styles just buzzed his hair. This is not a drill. Repeat, this is not a drill. In unrelated news, one of our producers, Maddie, has been seen laying across Mopac. No correlation at all. This week in ooze news, a mysterious green ooze was found in New York City, in the New York City sewers. Sounds like some certain turtle teens might be getting very mutated and ninja-y very soon. Actually, we're getting reports that the ooze is highly toxic and it has killed sanitation workers. That's awkward. Seems like Leonardo DiCinci has enjoyed a little bit of booty fondling from his girlfriend after the two stepped out of a Halloween party. The two are certainly getting to know each other on a deeper level. Oh my. She sank that finger in like it was the Titanic. Julie Diaz, the mother of Next Week Now cast member Spencer Diaz, has recently celebrated her 64th birthday. Woo! Yeah. To that, we at Next Week Now wish to say to her, happy late birthday, Miss Diaz. And to Ezra's mom, please don't be jealous. We'll be sure to have an extra special birthday surprise when your birthday comes around. Moving on, Homer Simpson will no longer strangle his son Bart Simpson in The Simpsons. Truly a sad day for dads who strangle their sons. Gypsy Rose Blanchard went on record saying that Taylor Swift taught her the true meaning of girl power. Woo. Wow. One feminist icon acknowledging the other. They'd be an unstoppable duo. Why, I bet they could even get away with murder. And finally, pop supergroup Boy Genius dressed as the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit this last week for their performance on Halloween, which also included Dave Grohl as their drummer. In other gay news, a spike in LGBTQ+ youth Christianity has been noted. Finally, everyone, I have an announcement to make. The moon landing was fake, guys. It was a production directed by Stanley Kubrick, made to sell moon rocks. The moon isn't even real. It's just a projection. It's done by the guys who project all those words onto the CMA. I'm glad I can finally get that off my chest. Now I have to go into hiding. But in more poo-poo news, it is my duty to now show you this bumper.
Someone call a plumber?
Yeah, well, it's... my toilet's being a real asshole.
Oh. I'm sorry. I thought that maybe we had some. Okay, let me go. Yeah, I'll go see you. Yeah,
sure. Fucking humans always fucking shitting in my mouth. Disgusting. Fucking hate people. Why? God. I could have been a person. I could have had legs. I could have been an engineer. But all I do is eat poop all day. Stupid, stupid, stupid.
Sounds like a tough case. How's about you leave this one to the professional?
Oh sure, let me guess. Size 34 pants, Snoopy underwear, mild to moderate skid marks. I've seen your kind before. Yeah, go ahead and pull them down. Let me see what we're working with. I've been through this before. Christ, man, do you drink any water? This piss is a dark yellow. God, it tastes like shit. It tastes like fucking garbage.
Well, hey, you have a bit of a sour attitude, mister.
Oh my God, what is that thing you're using? It's like a worm on the ground of a barber shop.
Hey, you better answer the question or else I'm gonna have to pull out the big guns.
No, please, I'll talk. Well, I guess it all started the first time I got used. I was young and naive and excited to have a purpose. But God, does that shit taste like, well, it sucks. No one has ever really treated me to a nice meal.
I find that hard to believe.
Well, believe it, sister.
A nice, humble, pure toilet like you hasn't been cooked a decent meal? If I had a toilet like you, I'd cook it a 3-course meal every day.
You don't mean that.
Oh, yeah? How does, lasagna sound?
What the hell?
Oh, yeah, eat that paper. Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, do you need to get burped?
Oh, honey, sweetie, you got a little stain. Let me get that for you. Oh, there you go, there you go.
Patty cake, baker's eyes.
Yeah, that was a rush right there.
Will you be my lawfully wedded toilet husband? I promise I'll take care of you.
This is a miracle! This is a miracle! You're almost there! Push! Push!
Honey, you gotta...
I need to get a replacement. I need to shave.
So, Sarah, what's going on here? Sarah? Sarah?
She won't answer you. Or she can't.
Why not?
This is the way it's been since she started smoking pot. She's all lazy and boring and... You know, we used to have so much fun together.
And now?
This is what we do.
Go! Yo, wait. Yo. I remember you guys. Dude, do you remember me? Dude, do you remember you? Hey, I remember you guys. I remember you guys from high school. Yeah, dude. Dude, you barfed really hard in Mrs. Hartwell's class when we were in sex ed. Yeah, dude, it was crazy. It was everywhere. Oh my god, it was so gross. Dude, do you remember? Do you remember the janitors had to wear hazmat suits when they picked up your barf? Yeah, dude, and your mom had to bring you a new change of clothes. Dude, that was crazy. Dude, that was wild. Dude, tell her I said hi. Okay. What's up with the news? A lost magic school bus episode will be discovered in PBS by resident cartoon fanboy and Coca-Cola addict Spencer Diaz. The episode will consist of Miss Frizzle's class learning about the human body by entering the colon of the show's main punching bag, Arnold. You know, the kid who looked like his parents just told him they're gonna get a divorce. Always. Arnold obviously was against the idea, but Miss Frizzle conveniently reveals his family's medical history of colon cancer, leading to him being forced into a colonoscopy. Here's a short clip. Well, now we know why it was hidden. Following this discovery, the PBS vault will be fully unlocked, allowing hidden episodes from many PBS shows to come to light. These will include the Lost Arthur episode about a gay rat divorce, a new episode of Sid the Science Kid about him discovering he has fetal alcohol syndrome, and the planned series finale of The Dinosaur Train that involves a new character, a meteor. A scrapped episode of Clifford the Dog that had him getting his big red balls removed. And finally, Curious George gets a bit too curious and mauls the man in the yellow hat. Actually, it appears we have more information regarding the Lost Curious George episode. Yikes. Hey, dude, do you remember when we saw the monkeys at that school field trip? Dude, in the sixth grade? Yeah, dude, didn't you try and kiss Shelby on that field trip? Dude, under the bird exhibit? Yeah, dude, didn't the bird poop right on your face when you asked her out? Dude, that was crazy. Yeah, her brother tried to shoot up the high school the following year. Swinging a miss. Next week, the Chicago bean is going to melt. You know, the big one. It's gonna melt. After a record-breaking heat wave of 250 degrees Fahrenheit, that will lead to the deaths of the entire Chicago population. The melted pile of bean will be found in Millennium Park. It seems the melted bean will be surrounded by various crispy and burnt away skeletons. Said skeletons will apparently be humans who burnt away in the heat wave. Which is crazy, because I always thought skeletons were skeletons and then like humans were humans. But whatever. However, the bodies will be left in their place as firefighters and first responders chip away at the bean in order to rebuild it. Originally, all male firefighters and first responders will not be able to find the bean, claiming it doesn't even exist. Okay. The bean itself will melt to a thickness of about a foot of metal, gooey gray sludge spreading across 500 feet of park grounds. Supposedly, tourists attempting to escape the heat wave will become trapped in the melting metal, burning their feet into ash. One child will supposedly become covered in ash. A photo taken, I don't know why we're laughing, because that's a child. A photo taken by Next Week Now photographer, this is serious, Michael M. Mosby shows the grisly moment. The child will never be recovered. Chicago Bean architect Anish Kapoor will be quoted as saying, "Despite the great losses in Chicago, we must persevere. These losses will fuel our future. We will carry on." Wait, my bean melted? Oh, dude, no, dang it, gosh darn it, my freaking bean! Hey, remember that guy in high school whose his nickname was Chicago Bean? Yeah, do you remember? Yeah, we called him that because he was eating beans in the wind, and they fell into his lap, and he looked like he pooped himself all day. Dude, that was so funny. Oh, that was crazy. Yeah, he killed himself last week. Our top story of the night is about a deadly drug ring that has infected the streets of West Campus, far deadlier and more addicting than kissing boys. That would be the investigation and busting of the Mexican Coke cartel. That's right, next week now's Austin's Finest, the West Campus Ambassadors, will expose a major ring involving the distribution of Mexican-produced Coke, a cola. It will be declared a statewide emergency by Greg Abbott. The ring will be busted after a bunch of grad students will be seen at the border, sucking on comically large straws that go over the border wall. Apparently, this has been in operation since Texans discovered that Mexican Coke is, quote, well, really frickin' tasty. When investigating UT, a large shipment of Mexican Coke, a cola, will be discovered in a hidden heap inside Bevo, shoved up his thing that starts here and then changes the world. Due to budget cuts, Greg Abbott will hire the two dumbest cops on the case, which are just cops, mostly due to the fact that he can pay them less than he would for those who would do a good job, which is none of them, they're cops. The two will discover numerous pushers and addicts, including T-Swizzle, Now Boy, Anash Ole, the late Spencer Diaz, Jay Fart Smell, who's also being charged with embezzling student tuitions to feed his addiction, and the dons of the cartel, Ferris's evil brother, Bueller, who will later flee the scene and seek asylum at the University of Oklahoma. The war room will be turned into a Coca-Cola Anonymous meeting place, which would confuse everyone who believed that this is not real Coke. To help you guys better understand the true addicting power of Mexican Coke, we've brought along a foreign scientist to answer these questions.
Hello! Thank you, guy from high school. Now, to better understand the addicting powers the Mexican Coke that it possesses over people, I have brought an entire bottle of Coca-Cola made in El Paso.
El Paso's in Texas.
It's dangerous.
Pull that out of your butt.
As you can see, the appeal comes from the combination of nostalgia and feelings of satisfaction, depending on the scent and the flavor. You see, the bottle is a classic glass bottle, calling to mind a classic nostalgic feel. Feeling the opening the bottle. The sound of the fizz and the scent is highly inviting and gratifying.
Yeah, you pulled that out of your butt.
As for the taste.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I need to take more notes. I'll be right back.
That's crazy. He pulled that right out of his butt. Cut to correspondent.
Whoa! I messed it up.
Uh-huh. Just like loop it again.
Whoa!
Austin, Texas, specifically Peter Pan mini golf.
All right, I'm ready.
Now that this is officially a correspondence segment, it's the Next Week Now mini golf competition. We're here to find out who is the best at mini golf at Next Week Now, and the loser dies. The loser gets shot.
No.
That's right. That's
right. For legal reasons, I would like to clarify that it is not official Peter Pan mini golf policy that the loser gets shot.
You killed me.
I killed her, and that will happen to the loser of this competition. We do not want people on Next Week Now who suck at mini golf. We do not want our very, very well-built reputation tarnished by such horrible, horrible, skillless, talentless, little piles of snot, all right? And because of that, we're going to make sure that that person is eradicated off the face of the earth. It's kind of like the Hunger Games. Except only one person dies, and it's the last person.
How many pieces do you wish? You have to pick a number.
One.
Well, you're out.
So I'm first, okay.
Wait, so no. You just target what?
Wait, is that how we're doing?
What are we picking?
You just one whenever stroke you're done, all took. Write it down. Whenever you're done.
Yeah, everyone keep track of
all right, one stroke. Stroke.
That's not how my name spelled.
Go! Yeah!
Suck. Damn
it. How do you feel about that?
Feel pretty good.
I'll get like a bowling.
Come on.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
The intention is there. Mini golf master champion. Eight-time champion does what they do. All right.
So good. So
talking
good.
All that trash. That's actually amazing.
So impressed.
Can I get your autograph?
That was one. That counts as one.
Two.
Yes.
Two. That counts as two.
You had to reset.
Sorry.
Ray, can you move?
We were taking so long. People started passing us, so we're gonna go to the other course.
Cause we're too good for this.
Cause we're too, this is too easy. This is honestly way too easy for me.
Mini golf is like war.
Sometimes you have to skip a few holes. Sometimes you gotta kill a few people.
Izzy, what's it like all the way down there? Oh, they're at last.
Nice and warm in hell, thanks. Getting hotter.
Hey Kenzie, I'm starting to think you're bad at the game.
Oh my.
Guys, all your balls there. All at once. Alright, we're ready? And we're gonna race it. No order. Okay, just keep going until you get in the hole. Okay, you guys ready? Steady, start! Out of there! Wait, hit the blue one back at me! Hit the blue one! Come on!
No, I missed!
Oh, let's go! 700 points!
Oh my god!
Oh, what?
I got it in! Stop.
Tiger Woods over here, come on. I've come to a realization.
We all suck at golfing.
This is for Poland.
So's this one.
Okay. They call me Handsy because I'm very handsy.
This is for World War II, you bastard.
It's almost in! Yeah! No!
Mr. Pan, it's the boy who never grew up. I got the Nazi to spread his legs for me. Check this out. I call this under the crotch crochet.
Ugh. It's a blue ball. Paris, it's a blue ball.
Yeah.
Have you seen people watch
Billy
this
Madison.
Like
Wii Sports?
Have you seen people just watch this like straight up golf, like unfiltered raw golf on the TV?
No.
I've watched that Mr. Gaddy's, yeah.
Like they just sit there, they watch golf like it's a legitimate sport.
Ferris's look. Sorry, buddy. Can we execute Ferris? So that would be really funny.
So you're saying I'm the one getting shots?
That's why we're caving him.
Hey, whoa, wait, guys.
Technically, you're not last yet until you pick one.
What's last words?
Ferris is getting executed, guys!
Yay!
Before we do that, we have to outro the correspondent, don't we?
Oh,
right?
Duh.
Right? Anyway.
Attention parents and grandparents of young children. Gerber Life is accepting applications for their affordable grow-up plan. The grow-up plan gives your child $10,000 in whole life insurance protection now, then doubles automatically to $20,000 later at no extra cost. Free information will be sent to parents and grandparents who call now. Help give your child a head start for just pennies a day. Don't wait. Call now for free information.
Call 1-800-829-8866. Call now.
Introducing Ferris, more like hairless.
Hi. So as you guys saw, today hasn't been the best day for me. I, you know, cat's a sandwich, toilet husband died, too good at mini golf, German. Anyway, I wanted to do something nice for myself, and I feel like all of these people, the crew, are willing to do something nice for me by trimming my beard. It might be no shave November, so I'm just trimming it. I'm just getting a little trimmed off, guys. So just keep that in mind. I just want something, you know, kind of good looking, maybe something a little sexy. If you could do that. I have a trimmer. These are the Arsenal. I have a trimmer. I have a razor with razor cream, and I have a cup of water for the razor cream. Okay, guys, you all can come up and take a swipe, I guess.
Yeah. Yeah. Hey, Jake. Fellow beard haver.
Uh-huh.
I'm sorry that I have to do this to you, man.
What do you mean? You're just gonna trim it a little bit, right?
Yeah, okay, so what would you prefer I use?
Whatever gets the job done. Why are you staring at me like that? I put a little guard on there. I don't know if you want. Okay.
Whoa. You said one strike. Stroke. Right?
One strike. Stroke. I just want you to know I have a guard there so that it's easier to.
Right.
Okay.
Oh well, that's lame. Barely anything came out.
That's okay. That's a little uneven. That's fine. But it's fine. You're gonna get
whatever.
Gonna get the other side, right? Zach?
Hi, Ferris.
Hey. You're gonna do you need that much just to trim
cream
a beard? I don't know.
Cream on Ferris. Cream on Ferris.
Okay. It's really cool. Wait. Well, how much are you getting off? How much are you saving up? What are you doing? Oh, okay. Shoot. Oh. That's okay. Just that's... Brady, I know you wear glasses, so you're gonna... That helps you to see, right? looked at the this is gonna come back around to being trip.
I'm gonna need you to tilt your head back. Or.
Okay, wait, I just want to tell you, okay? Everything you do is like permanent. It's gonna take me like, it's gonna take me like eight years to grow
It'll
this back.
Grow back.
I've been growing this since I was like 12. Can I just have a safe word or something?
Okay, yeah. What's your safe word?
Don't shave me.
Too late.
Okay. Ah!
Ah! Nothing came off at all.
Oh, it's because I put a guard there. You need to take the guard off.
Take the guard off. Do I get another gun? Because nothing came out.
Yeah.
Oh no. No.
Sorry. Back.
Okay. Please be gentle. Oh! 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 This is god awful. You're a sweetheart. You're not gonna do it.
I'm so excited. Wait. You only got that side, so I think. Me do this side. Hold a little still. Good luck.
I thought you were a sweetheart. You're not a sweetheart. I do not trust you. I don't know what horrible thing you're gonna do to my face.
Are you supposed to go up with it?
But make it quick.
Are you supposed to go down with it?
Down.
Typically against the grain.
Okay, lift your head.
Unless you want to take a lot off.
Okay, lift your head.
I was already bald there. I already had a ball. It was already so hard to grow hair in that area. Oh my god. You're a monster! Why with the cream? Why is everyone trying to cream on me today?
There you go.
Was there not enough cream on that side?
No.
Did you just wipe that on your butt?
I don't fucking care. I'm scared.
You're using the trimmer with the cream?
The other way to the cream.
Someone hasn't had a beard.
What do I do?
What do you want to do? I don't know.
Where's the razor?
This is like long gone. I'm gonna have to wear a hat forever until my hair grows back.
A hat on your face. A beard net, if you will.
There you go.
It sounded so weird. It went like... I don't trust you guys. I'm gonna put my hair back, okay? I don't...
Hello, Ferris.
Oh, hi, Adam.
How's it going?
Not good!
As a former fellow beard haver, I have to get down. I'm tall. I feel you, Ferris.
Adam?
Yes?
You're named after the guy that sinned humanity. Isn't it time that you start repenting? You start making up for it?
Do it, Adam. God sent me to do this mission.
I'm going to hell. This is how I find out I'm going to hell. Don't you have your own beard to shave?
Yeah.
How long did it take you to grow yours back?
Not that long.
That's good.
Okay, hold still.
It'll come back, Ferris.
Okay. It doesn't hurt, by the way. It's like, I kind of made the boo-boo a little better.
You go up.
Okay.
They shaved the bit I wanted to shave.
I'm sorry, finders keepers. It's cream again? Is there not enough cream on the side of my face? You guys could have styled me.
Don't worry. I'm growing the mustache. I know you could grow it back.
That didn't come most, but it like made it uneven.
You just put a bunch of cream on my face!
You didn't even shave it off!
Stop it!
Love you, Ferris.
It does look safe, we're just don't shave my ears.
Sasha!
Hey. Sasha! Oh, have you no soul? You just got the other side that Yvonne got. You guys have a golden opportunity you're wasting here.
So... So how bad would you be if I just went right down your head?
Get the eyebrow.
Very.
Go for the eyebrow.
I really didn't.
Your eyebrow?
I was looking at you the whole time on the line, and I was like, I don't want this person in the room. Are you supposed to be directing the episode? Can't you go back to master control?
Can I shave your chest? Can I shave your chest?
Two swipes!
Ray didn't get to. I did it for Ray.
I'm blowing bubbles.
Yes.
You guys just creamed all over my face and left.
Yes. Luca.
I don't know how to use this.
We're not allowed to
Luca. For Poland.
All right. You got
one. Oh.
All right. I don't know how I'm gonna do this. So. I'm also gonna.
You're doing chest? I didn't even come here for chest! I didn't come here for chest! I came here for my. Wait, watch the nipple! Watch the nipple! Watch my nipple!
Technically, that was one swipe. I'm gonna take some souvenirs.
Oh my god! Oh my god!
Anyone want this?
Yo, Ferris, you're looking sexy.
I'm breathing in cream.
No, I'm just gonna.
I genuinely.
Give me, some big upper lip. Give me some big upper lip, big boy.
Hey, baby.
No, we're getting the entire thing. Come on.
Okay, thank God. I thought you were doing a Hitler stash.
No, we're just getting half of your stash.
Okay. So you do this kind of thing often?
Clearly not. I'm quite bad at it. Oh my god, look at how thick that is.
Rinse it off because it's got cream on it.
Oh yeah.
Oh, here, I got you.
No, don't wash it with water.
What? Ew, okay.
Okay.
Come on.
Okay. Sorry.
Ooh.
Nice and used.
What do you want?
Okay.
Guy from high school. I didn't go to high school with you.
Remember that time I shaved F and E into your chest?
Okay. Wait, maybe we did go to high school. Oh no!
Okay.
Why are you? Why F and E?
F E, cause Ferris Ezra.
Oh,
make a heart.
That's so nice. Yeah, make a heart. If you're gonna destroy my body hair.
I'm not very good at this.
My masculinity's being taken away from me.
Oh, your masculinity being taken away from
you. Make it lovey-dovey.
Talk to the hand about masculinity being taken away from people. You know, I just got my chest hair. Oh.
I'm gonna steal some of his chest hair. Let me tell you.
How do I
need revenge!
Oh, it's just like that? Okay, here, you gotta look up. I'm getting the neck, buddy.
Maddie, you don't have to do these kind of things.
I mean, I kind of do those. I'm kind of look back. To back. There we go. Yeah. There you go.
Do you want two swipes? You're nice. You could get two swipes.
I'm getting two swipes. I'm helping you out, really. There you go. I'm so sorry.
Does that help me out? I can't see down there. Someone tell me if that helps me.
It does.
Sure, three swipes. Go on. Three swipes and you're out.
Thank you.
Oh my god, you look like that guy from Bridgerton.
What the hell?
Swipe or no swipe?
I'm so sorry. Here you go, Edgar.
Looks like it's us two again. Alright, look up for me and just relax, okay? Don't be so tense. Come on.
I'm breathing.
Take a deep breath in here. Come on.
You turned this on. Oh, never mind. It's the power button. All right. Hey, 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 calm down. Calm down for me. Speak to me.
My side burns. Just operate on me, doctor.
Yeah? Look at that.
What? Can that even be seen on camera?
No. Yeah.
Don't you have a station to manager? Wow.
Thank you, actually. That's very nice.
This looks nice.
This looks good.
What can I
say? Wait, the mustache does. Are you serious? How am I gonna get a job? Oh my. Please get rid of the mustache.
Tilt your head back.
Oh no! Why are you keeping the mustache? Wait, that's three, that's four, that's five, you got five, six, you got seven, eight, nine, ten.
No one else is in line, I'm the last one, I'm fixing it up, this is the final.
Okay.
Just thank close you. Your eyes and it'll be over really soon, Ferris.
Does it look alright? Does it look good?
Yeah. You're really handsome, Ferris.
Thank you. You know, I've never been called handsome before.
Yes, you have.
Yes, you have.
I've called you handsome before.
Well, only by people's moms.
Oh. That's the highest compliment.
Yeah.
But no one, like, real.
Wow. No, wait, my mom isn't real.
Ferris isn't real? Wait, no,
leave.
Are mothers
not real people?
No. Yeah. Only when she looks in my eyes do I see her as real. This kind of feels nice, actually.
It really is. It looks great.
So anyway, you guys want to hear some beard jokes?
Yeah.
Why did the barber win in the barber race, the annual barber race?
Why?
Because the barber knew all of the shortcuts.
What?
And poked knives into the tires of the other barbers.
Is that, I think, no, you gotta keep it like that.
Yeah. That's it. That's it. Mm-hmm. Screw you guys.
What a handsome fella. Welcome back to Next Week Now. I was just thinking about that time in the 10th grade that you accidentally laughed while we were talking about the Holocaust, because you were looking through the history book and found fiction someone wrote about King Tut and Nixon. Didn't you fail the AP history exam? I'm your host, a guy you know from high school, and today's special guest is this mime we found outside of the In-N-Out. Can I shake your hand? Oh, wait. Oh, I can't shake your hand. There's a box. Oh, okay. And we also have our in-studio translator who can conveniently translate mime, Tracy. So, Mr. Mime, how are we feeling on being here for tonight?
Yeah, he says that he's feeling unsure about this.
Oh, would you care to elaborate more on that, Mr. Mime?
Don't quote me on this exactly, but I think he's a bit upset because his fortune cookie didn't have a fortune in it.
Tracy, are you sure that's what he's trying to say? This feels like a heart.
Do you, like, not know who I am? I'm Tracy the translator. I've been here, like, way longer than you have.
Well, I'm starting to question your legitimacy here, Tracy.
Oh, you're questioning my...
Sorry, Tracy.
Here's my degree. Where's your degree on hostology, Mr. Host?
This is not only not a degree, it's an unfinished screenplay. Okay, well, I'm the host, so I don't want you to talk anymore. Can I do that? Yeah, okay. No more talking. Okay. Back to you, Mr. Mime. So you're feeling heartbroken, right? feeling like you need something to fill the hole in your heart.
Now, maybe? Don't quote me on this, but I'm certain that he's saying that he's happily fulfilled in life and wishes to explore more of it. I mean, look at how happy he is right now.
Tracy, he clearly was agreeing with me, the host, about not feeling good about his life and feeling incomplete.
Well, clearly you're being self-centered because this isn't just your show. I've been the translator here for far longer than you've been, like, alive even. Now, what I'm interpreting from Mr. Mime is that he's clearly happy, prideful, and well-experienced in his career path in life, unlike you.
Well, okay, well, look at him, Tracy. He has tears painted on his face. What about that signals happiness?
Well, I can see people for who they truly are, unlike you, who just judges a book based on their cover. And those are clearly tears of joy. I don't understand how you could be so oblivious.
Okay, whatever. Listen, back to you, Mr. Mime, the real guest and star of this show. Are you happy in life? Are you content? Do you think what you're doing, like, means something to anyone in this world? Okay. That seems sad. Mr. Mime, what is your outlook in life?
Well, he's saying rope here.
Okay, that is rope.
Yeah.
I guess I can completely agree with you that. That's rope.
Well, clearly you shouldn't have doubted me before, because this is why I have a degree in translation, is rope.
Okay, well, I don't see why you're arguing with me on this still, because...
not arguing.
Because he's clearly saying rope, and I agree. You're obviously giving me attitude on this, and I just don't think that you like me, which is kind of weird, because we just met.
Well, I'm just not giving you anything, and you're obviously misreading everything, and that's why you're not a translator, and I am.
Okay, well, I think that this... Okay, I think... That's... Oh, my God. Oh, okay. We're too far. Oh, my God. Mr. Mime, are you okay?
What?
Is that real?
What? He's clearly saying that he's hanging in there.
No.
There's clearly, like, many low points in life as we humans persevere and rise out of those low points to continue living our lives.
Tracy, he wants to kill himself.
He's hanging in there.
What did you not understand from that?
Oh, wow. Of course, a pessimistic person like yourself would assume the worst and radiate that negative energy you have to everybody else. And unlike me, who makes sure to have an optimistic view on everything, which is why I think that I'm a better role model than you are.
He's not our child. And also, no, you're not. Wanted to kill himself.
Where's your degree? Where's your degree?
Your degree's on the floor, and it's not real.
It's literally, oh, so what? I also write scripts. The strike is over. I'm on the job now. I'm about to quit this job.
Good, because you suck, dude.
I've done everything that I can do, and people still don't listen.
You suck. Isn't that right, Mr. Mime?
Matthew! My name is Matthew! I have a name! It's not Mr. Mime, it's Matthew! Matthew! You wanna know why he called me Mr. Mime? Because you just assume that, like, I guess mimes just are, like, not people with, like, you know, feelings and all that. I have feelings, you know?
I found you outside the In-N-Out.
Clearly you aren't a good mime because I couldn't understand any of that. And, well, I have a degree in translation, so... Drama queen, am I right?
I know. And rude, too. Jeez. Well, Mime tired of this guest bit. So I think we're gonna wrap things up here. Thanks for shaving our friend. Thanks for going mini golfing with us, amongst other things. Thanks for hanging in there with us. And my final prediction of the night is you'll be back next time. Good night.